Ashley Letecky Ellenboss with Sky House Herb School and Apothecary. And today we're going to be looking at how to reset your body and mind after vacation. Because I know for me, when I travel, sometimes the return home is actually more challenging than the packing and preparing for the trip. And often, you know, for me, when I go on vacation, I tend to indulge more in things that might not be part of my normal regime. And so often when I return from a vacation, I need some help grounding and getting back to good habits. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that. Before I do, I want to invite everyone here to our Summer Herbal Speaker Series, which starts this Saturday, July 24th, and will extend all the way through till August 21st. And we have a wonderful lineup of speakers. Every single speaker series class is free, so you can register and save your spot at no cost. And we have, starting us off, we have Tokumba Obasi, who is going to be talking about root medicines, then Karen Culpepper, helping clinical herbalists or people who are interested in practicing herbal medicine, vision, ways to get their herbal practice going. This is going to be a super fun, interactive, very, you know, high participation type of event. Then we'll have Richard Mandelbaum, who will talk about how not every herbalist is human. He'll talk about how a lot of animals are actually herbalists as well and what that looks like. And then we'll be closing with myself and Matthew Wood, who's going to be here in this space, probably over there in our chairs at our little lounge setup. So he'll be with me here to talk about astrology and herbs for the summertime and kind of leading into the autumn. So that's going to be really, really fun. So please come, tell your friends. You can go to skyhouseherbs.com/events to sign up. All right, now on to today's topic. So, and I guess, as I said before, you know, the main things that tend to happen when we go on vacation is that a lot of our routines get really messed up. Our eating patterns can get a little bit slippery, right? We can tend to indulge in more things than we often would. And just traveling is quite stressful on our bodies and minds. And so I'm going to talk about herbs and ways that we can actually help support our emotional body in transitioning back home. So let's first start off. I have four main tips for you for how to successfully reset after vacation. And the first tip is to unpack right away. This is something my husband, Achyuta, taught me because I tended to be of the mind of like, let's get home and let's relax because travel was so stressful. And he always has said, no, get home and unpack and like, get everything cleared. And since I started doing that, I'll tell you, it is way better because then you can relax once everything is cleared. So I recommend get the clothes in the laundry, put your toiletries away. Hopefully if you were able to clean the house before you left, you're coming home to a clean house. But if not, do the dishes, do the vacuuming, kind of get everything really in a good space so that you can settle in to your home and kind of turn the page on what just happened. Also, if there's any odds and ends that are from your trip, like for me, it's a lot of kid paraphernalia, like swimmers and goggles, put all those where they belong. You know, everything should have a place. So make sure everything finds its way back to that place as soon as possible, ideally within that first day, those first 24 hours of returning home from a trip. The second thing is to start Operation Hydration. Because traveling, often when we travel, we don't drink a lot of water. And part of that is because we're traveling. So we don't want to have to be stopping all the time, or if we're, you know, in public transport, we don't necessarily want to be going into closed contained spaces where you're breathing a lot of recycled air and being around germs. So, you know, you may have gotten dehydrated either from the travel or not drinking enough water or from the entire trip, especially if you were in a very dry climate. You know, you might not even realize you're dehydrated. So a few ways to check is to look at the tips of your fingers. If they're a little bit wrinkly, then that's often a sign that you're a little, you know, they get pruned a little bit, not from being in water, but if you're just, you know, you've been out of the shower or the bath and your fingers are a little bit pruny, you probably are dehydrated. You can look at your tongue. If your tongue looks dry, you're probably dehydrated. And if your urine is very dark, then you're probably dehydrated. So I would start Operation Hydration as soon as you get home, you know, get a quart jar or some favorite water bottle and just start drinking and try to make, you know, try to get it so that your urine is clear. For at least, you know, ideally you want to have it clear by like 9 a.m. and by 3 p.m. Those are sort of two good markers that I learned from one of my fitness coaches at 39 Minute Workout. Shout out. Check them out. They do wonderful online and in-person kettlebell training classes. But David Beers, he, you know, swears by that. And I have to say, I always feel better if I can really drink, start off my day with a huge glass of water and really make sure that I'm peeing clear at those two time markers. Then number three is integrate the good vibes. So bring the good vibes home. So whatever was good about your trip, you know, sometimes when we have trips and vacations, there's things that are not good, but what were the things that you really loved? Maybe it was the music you were listening to. Maybe it was a certain scent in the air that you can bring into your home. Maybe it's the clothing you wore. You really liked wearing airy open dresses or sandals or something like that. Just, or if there's pictures that you took that you can frame and get those integrated into your scenery right away. Those are all really good ways to help you continue to process what happened during the vacation and also to have that, the one of the main gifts of a vacation is having those good memories to look back to. And when your whole body will have that like, ah, response when you think about those joyful moments. So start to imprint those into your space when you arrive home. Now, the fourth thing are the herbs. These are the plants that can be helpful in resetting your body and your mind. Let's talk about, I would say, the first and most important herb that I went to right away when I got home, because for me, we were visiting family and there was a lot of ice cream and there was a lot of sweets. And for my body, when I eat too many sweets, I start to get eczema. And I know it because I start to get these little itchy spots. And so as soon as I started feeling that, I was like, I need nettles. Nettles is one of the best alternatives, which cleanses the body from toxins, from metabolic wastes, from sugars, from anything that needs to be flushed out. Think of it as like a green flusher. And so what I did as soon as I got home is I grabbed my nettles. These ones I bought from Mountain Rose Herbs, but you can buy organic nettles from a lot of different herbal suppliers. And I made an overnight infusion. So I've been drinking this the last few days since we've returned home. And this is the one that I made last night. So I put probably about maybe 3/4 of a cup of nettles in here. I sprinkled in a little bit of Tulsi or holy basil because it's an adaptogen. And I know my body really loves that, but you don't have to. You can just do 3/4 of a cup of nettles, which is a lot, but you're going to need it. Then you fill it up to the top with hot water that you just boiled and cap it and let it sit overnight or at least, you know, 8 hours or so. And then let me just show you, I'm going to turn my camera angle, move my notes out of the way. And I'm going to show you how easy it is because all you have to do is see, did you hear that seal? That's a good sign. Is you just have to strain it into another jar. And so I just have this little strainer that sits on top of cups or other jars. And all I'm going to do is just pour it through. Can you see that nice, rich, it's like a brown, green color. So nettles is not only a detoxifier and an alternative or altering the body's processes of metabolism, but it's also full of nutrients. It's full of phytochemicals, vitamins, minerals, you name it. And nettles is like a powerhouse. It's like a superfood. So I'm just going to press out any remaining juice from my nettles. And then this becomes your sort of daily drink. And I like to drink mine in the first half of the day. And the reason for that is, well, number one, that's a really good time to just sort of reset your intention for the day. Also, it's a diuretic. So it's going to make you pee, which again is good. However, you don't want to be up peeing all night. So I would recommend just drinking it. And if you really are low in minerals, your body, you're going to start drinking it and you're going to be like, I didn't even know I needed this, but you do. Now, the only thing is if you tend to run really hot, then Nettles is considered to be warming, but if you're really depleted, it tends to not do that. But if you do tend to run really on the hot side, you might want to counterbalance it with a cooling herb. Something like marshmallow root would work really nice, or you could do rose petals, rose hips, anything that's a little bit cooling in nature. But I would still say, like, I tend to run hot and dry. However, I still do fine with nettles, especially when my body needs it like now. So drink a quart a day. This is a quart jar. So drink a quart a day for 5 to 7 days to really flush and nourish your body. The second herb is, or I guess I should say class of herbs, are bitters. Now, bitters are really, really nice, especially if you've indulged in fatty foods or alcohol or any recreational thing that is taxing on the liver. What is so nice about bitters is that they go right on the tongue. You don't need a lot of them. They also help to stimulate digestion and digestive secretions. So they're going to help improve your digestion. And I have some different bitters formulas here that I grabbed from my apothecary. And so I'll share these with you. And so the first one is, this is one that I made. We don't sell this anymore, but we did used to sell it at Sky House. This one's called Lakshmi's Lavender Bitters. And so I made a tincture. This one contains hops, wormwood, chamomile, and lavender. So that's a nice blend. This is a bitters blend called Swedish Bitters. It's one that you probably will be able to find at most health food stores. Let's see if that brings it into focus. Yep, there it is. So you can buy yourself some Swedish bitters. My friend Jamie at Barking Crow Wellness makes these warming digestive bitters or warming bitters. These are really nice. These ones have organic dandelion, orange peel, rosemary, star anise, black pepper, cloves, gentian, burdock, spruce shoots, cardamom, lemon peel, artichoke leaf, rose hips, brandy, and raw honey, and of course, love. So this is a really nice one too. You just spray it like so, and you get aromatic, yummy bitters. And so with bitters, what you want to do is you want to take them right before you eat each meal. So just take maybe 2 sprays or maybe 3 to 5 drops directly on your tongue before breakfast, before lunch, and then before dinner. And that'll kickstart digestion, help boost the activity of the liver, and help you, you know, also along with the nettles, help to cleanse and clear and reset your body. So that's really nice. The third one is emotional support. So, you know, it doesn't, you might not need emotional support every trip, but I know a lot of times, you know, traveling, and especially when you're with family or with large groups of people, you know, it can just kind of, there can be a lot new information to process. So I brought some of my favorite emotional supporter herbs that I thought would be really good and relevant for post-travel. Okay, so white pond lily. White pond lily is a really nice one. you can buy it from Eclectic Herbals. This one is from Stockich, S-T-A-K-I-C-H. But white pond lily or Nymphaea odorata is the Latin name. It's really good if you're the type of person that when you come home from a trip, like all this stuff has gotten stirred up. Like maybe past traumas, if you've been spending time with family, or regrets, or just, you know, like if you're feeling like that trip really stirred things up, and mostly like first and second chakra stuff around security, safety, sexuality, all of that, then white pond lily is really good at clearing that out. It's like flushing the toilet of those first and second chakras. It just really starts to clear and can help you process. A lot of times people that take white pond lily, my students and clients will say that their dreams get really vivid, that they actually can, their psyche starts to process things. So if you feel like that would be really helpful, then white pond lily, you can do 1 dropper full several times a day. The second one is Easter lily. So Easter lily, here we've got two lilies. Easter lily is Lilium longiflorum. This one is made by Bear Wallow Herbs. This is my friend Kara, who lives out on Mount Shasta, and she makes wonderful tinctures. So she's one of the few people that actually makes this one here in the United States. So Easter lily is a really good one for people that go back and forth between extremes. It's that black or white thinking, like that trip was the worst. It was the worst trip ever, or that was the best trip ever. Or, you know, maybe on the trip itself, you were going to extremes. You know, you threw care into the wind and ate like fried food at every meal and ate ice cream and drank a six pack, right? You just kind of let yourself go to an extreme. Easter lily is all about bringing extremes back into harmony, getting out of black and white thinking, because a lot of people that do that, they'll get home and then they'll be like, okay, I have to do a juice fast for a week, right? They'll go to the opposite extreme, which is actually extreme. You know, you don't need to overcorrect, right? Like the better thing to do is just say, okay, I went a little crazy. Where's the balance? Let me start from there rather than swinging to these extremes. So Easter lily as a subtle medicine is so good for that. It's also really good for stagnation, menstrual stagnation, breast stagnation. For men, it can just be really good. Also just for like kind of mental stagnation too, where you just sort of feel a little bit, you know, you have these extreme thoughts, but the energy is really kind of stuck, feeling stuck. So for Easter lily, this one I would take maybe 5 to 10 drops. You don't need a lot of it, up to maybe like half a dropperful or so, maybe like 15 drops would be the tops, and do that several times a day. The third one I have is pulsatilla or pasque flower. This is anemone patens. And there's a lot of companies out there that make this particular tincture. Pulsatilla is really good for the person who just feels weepy and depressed. So like, let's say you get home from a trip and you're like, nothing will ever be the same. I'm so sad, you know, like that's over. My life is not as good as that. And how did I get here? And why does my home life suck so bad? And that was so nice. So if you tend to like go down in the dumps and find yourself crying or weeping or just feeling like really sad, upon returning home, then this is a really nice medicine. Now, this is low dose. So this would be 1 to 3 drops several times a day. And then the last one is American ginseng. American ginseng to me is like a helping hand. So if you get home and you're just exhausted and you're like I'm exhausted and I need some, like I wish someone could come and help lift me up because I'm overwhelmed by being home, or I'm so tired after, you know, 4 flights being delayed, which I know is happening a lot these days, then you might want to start taking ginseng. Now, these other plants that I just mentioned, you can take them for maybe 1 to 2 weeks, but American ginseng would be a good one to take for like a month after you get home, if you're just feeling really depleted, run down, and like you could use. And the nice thing, the reason why I think of the helping hand is because this particular plant has 5 leaves. And so Matthew Wood, one of my teachers, would talk about it. It's like a helping hand. It's like, you know, its leaves look like this hand that's like, you know, I've got you. Don't worry. You'll make it through. So for ginseng, American ginseng, you know, you can take more of it, of this. So you could take like 3 droppers full, maybe once or twice a day. So this is higher dose. You could do like a teaspoon twice a day, something like that. So, shake it well, but do this longer because it's going to take you some time to build up your vitality. So I think that's all I have for you guys. I hope that's helpful. We talked about just to reiterate, our 4 main things were unpack right away, start operation hydration. Number 3, bring the good vibes home, integrate them into your space. And number 4 is use herbs like nettles, like your bitters, like these emotional supporters, to help reset your energy and help you integrate your way back into your daily life. So thank you for listening. Let me know what you thought. Let me know if you have any additional herbs you'd add into the mix or practices that help you transition and reset after traveling or vacationing. And I hope to see you all this Saturday for our first free talk of our herbal speaker series. Go to skyhouseherbs.com/events to register. All right. Thanks, everyone. Take care.